Hello everyone, I am Siddharthan. So currently we are in the fifth module of our machine learning course, and this module is all about mathematics for machine learning. So in this module so far we have discussed what is meant by vectors and what are some basic vector operations. So in the previous video was about some basic vector operations that included addition of two vectors, subtraction of two vectors and multiplication of a scalar by a vector. And this is the continuation of that video where we are going to discuss about some more vector operations. Okay, so in case you are watching my videos for the first time, hi. In this channel, I'm making a hands-on machine learning course with Python. And if you want to learn my course from the beginning, you can go to the playlist section of my channel where you can study my course from the beginning. Okay, so there will be videos module-wise. So with that being said, let's get started with today's video. So these are the topics which we will be covering in today's video. So first we will discuss about dot product of two vectors, and second we will discuss about the cross product of two vectors, and the third topic will be projection of one vector onto another vector. So these are the three topics. So first of all, let's discuss about dot product of two vectors. So let's say that we have two axes, two coordinate axes, x1 axis and x2 axis, and we have two vectors here. So the first vector is 2, 3, so and the second vector is 4, 4. So in the previous videos we have discussed what these values represent. So these values are nothing but the coordinates of this particular point, and it represents the vector, this particular vector. So if you are not sure about this, you can go and watch that video. So I'll give the link for that video in the description of this video. Now let's discuss about this dot product. So here we have the two vectors, so 2, 3 and 4, 4. Okay, so now let's see how we can calculate the dot product. So it is just multiplication of two vectors. So a dot product is, you know, specified by just putting a dot between the two vectors, and when you just find the dot product of the two vectors, what we will do is, so both the vectors should have the same shape. Here the, you know, both the vectors are in the form of two rows and one column, right? So we have 2 and 3, so two rows and one column, so the second vector is also of the same shape. Okay, so now we can dot product this, and what we will do is we will multiply both the coordinates, both the first coordinate. So here the first coordinate is nothing but 2 and 4, so this is nothing but the x coordinate, right? So if you take this point, this is nothing but the x coordinate here is 2 and y coordinate here is 3. So for this vector, the x coordinate is 4, this y coordinate or x2 coordinate is also 4. So what we will do is, first we have to multiply both the x1 coordinate, so here it is 2 and 4, so we have to multiply these two values, and we have to multiply the second coordinates, which are 3 and 4. So you can see here, so these two values will be multiplied and it will be added to the, again 3 and 4 will be multiplied and both these values will be added. So you can see here, so it is the sum of the products of the coordinates. So it is 2 into 4 plus 3 into 4, and the result which we will get will be 20. So this is the dot product of two vectors. Here the main thing that you need to note here is, when you perform dot product of two vectors, the resultant you get will be a scalar. So scalar is nothing but a numerical value or a constant. So it is not a vector but a numerical value. Whereas if you add two vectors or if you subtract two vectors, the resultant you will get will be a vector. Whereas when you perform dot product, the resultant will be a scalar. Okay, so if you want to find this graphically, let's say that you want to find this from this kind of graphs, there is a formula which we can use for finding the dot product. So let's say that this represents the A vector and the second vector represents B vector, and the angle between them is theta. Okay, so in the previous videos also I have explained you how you can find the angle between two vectors. So once you have that angle, the dot product can be given as, so A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector multiplied by magnitude of B vector into cos theta. Here theta is nothing but the angle between the two vectors. So as I have told you, I mentioned how you can find the magnitude of these vectors also in the previous videos. So how we will find the magnitude is, so if you take A vector, the magnitude will be square root of 2 square plus 3 square. So it will be like square root of 4 plus 9, which is equal to 13. So this is how you will find the magnitude of two vectors. And for B vectors, it will be root of 4 square plus 4 square, which is 16 plus 16, so root square of 32. So that is how you can find the magnitude of A vector and B vector. And once you find the angle between these two vectors, you can just plug in the values in this formula, and the value which you will get will be very close to this value, 20. So this is how you can find the dot product of two vectors. Now let's discuss about the cross product of two vectors. So let's take the same coordinate axis and let's take the same two vectors, 2, 3 and 4 comma 4. Okay, so now let's say that this is A vector and this is B vector, and theta is the angle between them. So if you want to write the formula is A vector cross B vector is equal to same magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector into sine theta. Whereas in the case of dot product, what we use is a cos theta. So that is the difference in the formula. Let's say that we want to find the cross product of two vectors. And another thing to note here is when you perform cross product of two vectors, the resultant you get will also be a vector. So it won't be a scalar as it is in the case of dot product. So the resultant of cross product of two vectors will also be a vector. So this is how you can find the resultant vector. So if you take A vector into B vector, so we need to write something called as determinant. So this is called as the determinant, which is, you know, similar to a matrix. And we have three axes here, I, J and K. So let's say that this X1 is represented as I, and J is represented by this X2, and K is the third dimension. So we don't have the third dimension value here. The third dimension value is 0. So now we need to put the values of this A vector and B vector in this determinant. So we can see here AX, AY, AZ, BX, DY and BZ. So this first line, this second line represent the A vector. So the A vector values, and this third line represent the B vector values. So you can see here we have plugged in the values. So we have this IJK, which are the reference coordinate axes. Okay, so here X1 is I, and this X2 represents J, and we don't have any values for K because this is the third dimension, whereas we have only 2D view here. Okay, so that values will be 0. Now let's put the values of A vector here. So AX will be 2 and AY will be 3. So you can see here we have put AX value as 2 and 3, and it is 4 for both the BX and BY, right? So we have put the values here. Now you can just do how we do a matrix multiplication. So in this case, what we will do is, so just finding the determinant value. So for this particular case, so let's say we need to take this I. So you can see here, so we have took this I here. Now just remove these two, so this row and this column. Okay, so remove that column, and you can see here now we need to multiply these two values. So 3 will be multiplied by 0, and it will be subtracted from this 4 and 0. So you can see here 3 dot 0. So 3 multiplied by 0 minus 0 into 4. So that value will be your I vector value. Okay, so our I coordinate value, and minus J. So now you need to take minus J, and now this particular column, this J column and this column should be neglected. Now again we should multiply 2 with 0, and it should be subtracted from 0 into 4. So you can see here, so we have took J, so 2 is multiplied with this 0, and 0 is again multiplied with 4, and it is subtracted. So it will be our J axis value, and finally we have K. Now we have to ignore this particular column and this row, and you can multiply this 2 into 4 minus 3 into 4. So we will get K value as this. So if you just find or calculate the values, what you will get is, so the I coordinate coefficient will be 0, for J also it will be 0, and for K it will be minus 4. So this is the vector that we are getting. So this is how you can find the cross product of two vectors. So we would have studied this in our 11th standard and 12th standard, how to find this value. And if you don't get this also, there is nothing to worry, because we will discuss in detail about this when we are discussing about matrix. So once we learn about matrix, this will make more sense to you. Okay, so this is how you can find the cross product of two vectors. Okay, so the next thing which we are going to discuss is projection of a vector onto another vector. Let's say that we have two vectors. So we have this A vector and V vector. Okay, and now let's say that we want to project this A vector to this V vector. So the purpose of this is to represent A vector in terms of V vector. So what we will do is, we will try to project this A vector onto V vector and just represent it in the direction of V vector. So I'll just draw a dotted line here, and this particular vector, so you can see this yellow color vector here, and this is our projection of A vector in terms of V vector. Okay, so this is called as projection of A vector on V vector, and the formula for this projection of A vector is A dot V. So it is the dot product of A vector and V vector divided by the square of the magnitude of V vector into V vector. Okay, so this is the formula which you need to remember. So this particular formula will give you the projection of A vector in terms of V vector, which represents like we represent A in terms of V, so in the direction of V. So this is how you can project one vector to another vector. So these are the remaining three important vector operations that you need to know. So in this video we have discussed how we can calculate dot product of two vectors, and then we have discussed how we can find the cross product of two vectors, and finally we have discussed how we can project one vector onto another, and we can find it with a projection formula. Okay, so these are the topics which we have covered in this video. I hope you have understood all the things we have covered here. In the next video, we will try to implement all these three concepts in Python and see how we can do that. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you have understood all the things covered in this. So, see you in the next video. Thank you.